Hello friends, welcome you all once again in lecture series Machining Science and Machine Tool. I am Amit Tiwari, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Suresh, Gyan, Vihar University, Jaipur. Today is the 16th lecture of this series, and the unit 3 is currently running, and the topic of the today lecture is Thermal Effect of Metal Cutting. The objective of the today lecture is to power consume in machining is largely converted into heat near the cutting edge of the tool. This causes the temperature of the tool, chip, and the workpiece to rise. This cause influences the property of the work material being machined, as well as the effective life of the cutting tool. Today, basically, we are discussing about the advantages of metal cutting, as well as the power consumption requirement of during the heat dissipated zone. Because we know that during the metal cutting, the heat are generated on the maximum on surface of the chip. And what are the effect of this heat to the correspondingly material and as well as the tool life. At the end of the lecture, the student will be able to understand about the thermal aspect of the machining, evaluation of tool and chip temperature during machining process using numerical methods. Temperature generated in machining operation significantly influence the chip formation mechanism, the purpose or the process efficiency, and the surface quality of the machine part. So at the end, the student are able to understand the temperature, how to maintain the temperature, what type of coolant we required for that temperature, and what are the heat dissipant area to overcome during the machining process with the help of some techniques or the numerical methods. So the temperature distribution in metal cutting is the most important factor because as we know that during the metal cutting, the friction is generated. And during the friction, and we know that the surface quality of the workpiece is more important because due to the friction, the heat is more generated. And if the heat is more generated on the workpiece, that means it may be chances that, or it may be fear about to change the microstructure property of the material. So for preventing the microstructure property of the work material, it is very difficult to understand how you to maintain the temperature, because if the too much temperature increasing in the surface, there are some aspirates are shown in the internal microstructure. If you see, we will also discuss in the last lecture, previous lecture. So the temperature distribution in metal cutting in workpiece and a chip during the orthogonal cutting obtained from an infrared photograph for pre-cutting in a mild steel where the cutting speed is 0.38 meter per second. And the width of cut is 6.35 mm, where the working normal rack angle is 30 degree and the workpiece temperature is 611 degrees Celsius. So it is just a normal temperature distribution of in workpiece and the chip during the orthogonal cutting. So the terms indicate that temperature distribution. Temperature distribution are the region where the chip interference are involved, where chip and tool are connected together, and the workpiece and the tool both are contact where the maximum amount of compressive forces are generated. Due to this, the maximum temperature will be generated at that time. And this causes to remove the surface from the material and to convert it into a chip where the 80% of the chip has converted in the energy into the heat, which is a very large section and very, we can say that the more amount of heat are generated on the plane of chip. That is shear plane, shear zone. That is we decreasing the temperature by improving the coolant or by improving the cutting parameters also. If you do not increase the variance, or we can say that the remove the material from the surface and during that coolant you will not provide, so maybe chances that due to the high temperature the some material are break, and maybe chances that most of the time the materials are burn, and it will increasing the blackheads on the points, and some aspirates are spots have been shown in the microstructure of material, which is destroy the property of material and also reduce the quality of the workpiece also. So for increasing the quality of surface quality, we will maintain the same temperature, and we will also maintain the some specific parameter, that is the spindle speed. Because when you are doing the spindle speed very high, that is the friction generated will be large. And due to the high friction generation, what will happen? It will be certain time, that means you can see here, if the modern machining technology, that is CNC milling machines and non-convection machines, have the special fluid used during the machining process. Because then now aware that if the temperature are increasing, that means that the quality of the tool and as well as the quality of the workpiece will be destroyed. It will not regain or reuse again after the once is used. So for better control, for better finishing, we just maintain the temperature, because temperature is the most important factor as we know that to improve or to decrease in the quality of the material. The width of the cut is just minimum about 6.35, they mentioned here, the speed of cutting speed at 0.38 meter per second. But the normal rack angle 30 degree and the workpiece temperature is 611 degrees Celsius. If you see in this diagram, just I'm showing the letter, doing the focus and giving the some importance of the temperature distribution in metal cutting. Because metal cutting is the phenomena to understand the basic structure of the workpiece material. Because if the workpiece material, if you cut and some structure are changes, that means the reducing the quality of the workpiece will be are on the machining surface. So we maintain the quality of the workpiece rather than to remove the unwanted material, and we decrease in the quality from that. So temperature distribution, that means the distribution are the other three zones. I have already discussed in the previous lecture, that is the shear zone, shear plan, and the chip thickness, chip tool interference, and the tool workpiece interference area. Where the chip area is heat is converted to maximum energy, that is 80 to 85%. Second, it is cheap tool interference, where the 15 to 20% energy is converted into heat. And last, that is the tool and workpiece area, where the 1 or 2 or 3% energy is converted into the heat. So these are some formation of we can say these are some formation of temperature or generation of the unwanted material to remove with the high speed of cutting speed to be maintained by the temperature with the help of the cutting fluids. This cutting fluid is required up to the water or to any other chemical agent which is used as the application of the material. Our application always be required for the material. Who was the what type of cooling we required for that? So to maintain the quality of the workpiece, to maintain the temperature distribution zone, we do not increase the temperature, we just maintain the temperature or to reduce the temperature. So how it is possible? It is possible by the coolant or some parameter we will discuss tomorrow. So these all are the fundamentals we required for that, or these all are the fundamentals we achieve by the proper standard format we required for the machining surface, and with some are the advanced machining required for the these operations. Because it is the part of the metal, because I'm just giving this that is introduction about the temperature distribution in metal. If you do not increase the temperature, if you do not maintain that quality of the workpiece, that is more important. You if it just you have no idea that is a mild steel if you selected for the workpiece, then what type of material is selected for the tool? It is selected more than the harder than the mild steel. After that, mild steel will be easily cut. And it did not, if they're not cut, that will mean it will reduce the surface roughness and very increase in surface roughness as well as to reduce the cutting edge of the tool, which is not dangerous, which is not required for the good machining. So for proper maintaining or as we can say that is a proper reducing the temperature, it will help to first of all to find out the good material and the property of that material, which is helpful to reduce the temperature and the surface roughness quality. More the rake angle, more the positive rake angle is good. But if rake angle is good and the spindle speed is not high, that is the speed in the that the top cut will be increasing. That is also the disadvantages we will get from the surface quality compromised by the machining profession. So for increasing the cutting speed, we just reminded that the feed rate also increase, and last it is decreasing the depth of cut. After that, it will be easy to understand temperature distribution in the metal cutting. So as you see in this diagram, you just mentioned here that is the diagram, this is a workpiece, and this is a tool where used to cutting the workpiece and formation of the chip, as you can see in this diagram. So what the diagram says, this is a workpiece and this is a cutting velocity, V is the cutting velocity. X plane, that is the maximum temperature occur on the surface of the chip. Y plane, where the minimum temperature occur on the surface of chip and tool interface. And last, that is a Z, that is the rare, that we can say a very little part affected by the temperature, that is 1 to 2 to 3% on the surface of the workpiece and a tool. So then this diagram they show that the maximum temperature, as you see here, to increasing from rapid to rapidly from 620 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. It is just up to the formation of chip generated during this time, the temperature will increase, because at that place, if you see that these are the maximum, which are 750 degrees Celsius, that is a chip tool interference where the formation of the chip are completely converted into the remove material, and this section are covered by the chip area. Because this chip area are basically no doubt at maximum thickness are covered, and due to the thickness, the heavy temperature are generated, and the high temperature will be not required for that. It will just graph show that you can see this graph is coming from the 680 degree to 690 degree in the inner portion. Because in the outer portion, outer side, that is the low portion starting, low temperature are here, and if you go to the internal end, the maximum temperature is generated at the surface of internally the chip and chip formation where started to the point. Because the where the chip form started, that you can see when a tool is striking on the surface and starting to formation of chip, where that at that point is the maximum temperature that occur, because it's the internal part where the maximum compressive forces are generated due to this, the temperature distribution are increasing. And now that is 620 degree, that is the end portion of the workpiece, and which is not affected much more as compared to the internal part, because internal part there is maybe chances some aspirates or some black spots or some buildup chip will be generated if they're not properly standard be required for the machining profession. It will be some time that will happen, but most of the time it will be just said at the 740 to 730 degrees as the temperature where the metal will completely convert into the plastic deformation and form convert into the chip. So these are the some standard formation, also some standard required to cut the material. But as for us to maintain the temperature also, because if you do not maintain the temperature, that is will remove the material but destroy the quality of the surface, and it is not affected by the good machining, which is required for the changing the temperature with the respectively of with the respective of the cutting fluid. So for maintaining the cutting fluid, for maintaining the quality of the workpiece, for maintaining the quality of the chip formation, for maintaining the tool and chip interferences, therefore we need to require a good coolant. Therefore, good coolant will help to you. We will also discuss some what type of coolant we use for and what are the properties of the coolant. We will also discuss in some lectures, previous lecture, next lecture. Today, our objective is to do temperature distribution zone, just to identify the what the temperature distribution zone in the metal cutting, because during the metal cutting, you just want to cutting of the metal by the tool. This workpiece is cut by the help of the tool and some formation of chip in this form you can see here. But the direction, that is our motto, is to find out the temperature distribution. Temperature distribution zone. So temperature distribution zone is not a difficult task to maintain, but it is the some little part you have to consider during the machining that you can check by the thermocouples or any other type of instrument to measure the temperature and the dead surface, because it is very necessary to understand that what temperature arrived during the machining operation. What happened, that is, if you do not understand and you have not find the machining temperature and what the effect of it, we will just maintain the quality of the workpiece for that. If you do not maintain the quality of, if we have not any idea what temperature of the machine is arising and what temperature we have limited, and with the limitation of the temperature, it is the must to understand the phenomena of cutting fluid we require for to maintain the temperature and to stop the we can say to slow the cutting speed or have then we increase in the cutting speed and tip top cut will be decreasing. So these are the under fundamental, or we can say that the cutting parameter will be adjusted as per the condition requirement or as per the required zone. So these all are the fundamentals we required for that to understand the quality of the workpiece or to maintain the surface quality. You can see the graph that is a 622 750 degrees Celsius are shown in the figure, which is completely the direction on the x-axis here, because this is this the formation of the chip, and you can see here these are the maximum area covered by that this temperature and the minimum area covered by the x-axis, because it has not affected too much. And after that there is a z-axis that is not affected by any other type of temperature, because this energy is very less converted into the heat. And at this place, it is the maximum energy converted heat, and another one that is that this is the second pressure zone where the minimum temperature has come to the net part of the body, in a part of the material. So this all are some temperature distribution zone are required to understand. These are some temperature distribution zone which is we understand. And if you're in doubt, it may be asking by ma'am. Which is the temperature where the temperature distribution zone is the affected area. And you can see in this diagram, which is 700 to 710, 720, 730, 40, 50. You can see this increasing the rapidly when the internally parts are affected by one by one, and we increase the temperature internally. The all metal are increasing, and all the part have the increasing the room temperature, which you can, if you measure by the thermocouples, etc. instruments. So it will help to you to understand the temperature distribution zone in the metal cutting you will be doing in the experiment in the lab. So the maximum temperature in the cutting zone occur not at the tool tip, but at some distance further up the rack angle, rack face. Material at the point such as the X reject, we can at the X gets heated as the pass through the shear zone and the finally leave as a chip. The for Y point such as the Y heated continuously beyond the shear plane into the friction heat region. This point wherever the loss heat shear zone heat to the chip while moving up the but the grain frictional heat. Points such as the Z remain in the workpiece and their temperature rises namely due to the conduction of heat into the workpiece. So these all are the some diagram just represent the three axis, X axis, Y axis, Z axis. But you can see these are the minimum temperature occur. Because this is the outside layer of the chip. There's a low temperature occur. But if you said it is a Y section, this is internally mid section here with maximum temperature occurred up to 750 degrees Celsius. And Z section we are the much more affected the heating of this area. So these all are the some area which are curvated by the X axis, Y axis, Y axis as per the diagram. Now the second it is measurement of chip tool interface temperature. Measurement of chip tool interface temperature, that is the flow or the various method of measuring chip tool interface temperature. First is a tool work thermocouple. Second, ambient thermocouple. Third, infrared photographic techniques. Temperature sensitive technique, temperature color, and indirect calorimeter techniques are the there are the various methods of measuring chip tool interface temperature. So with all these instruments, we will measure the various methods. By the tool work and thermocouple, we can obtain between the embedded thermocouple are used for between the workpiece and the tool, and so infrared addition by the you can see the photographs where the maximum heat are generated at the place we will detect it by this infrared radiation photographic technique. Temperature sensitive technique, it also indicated by the which area and which layer and what a time for operated temperature are increasing and decreasing at a certain time with respect to the workpiece machining operation. Temperature color that is shown that the different colors are indicated that the maximum temperature, minimum temperature, moderate temperature, or some temperature are not affected at place, that is shown on the extra color. That is will be a part of the how to measure the various for measuring chip tool interface temperature. These are the some measurement tools. There are the various techniques that I adopted during the machining, which is necessary to understand. If you don't understand, you are not aware about how you can calculate the temperature. If you require the maximum temperature achieved, but you have no idea, then there may be chance the metal will be damaged. So for that, you require the chip tool interface temperature for the purpose of maintain the quality of the workpiece. The first, it is that a tool work thermocouple technique is the most widely used technique for the measurement of average chip tool interface temperature. The other method suffer from the various activity disadvantages such as slow response, indirectness, and complications in the measurement. So some of the above methods are discussed briefly, that is indicated by the thermal technique to measure the temperature of a particular material and a workpiece also. So that is the thermal that we consider a tool work thermocouple. It is in this technique the hot end of the tool and the workpiece and the cold end at the thermocouple and at the electromagnetic force proportional to the temperature distribution is produced. So in this technique, the hot end of the tool and the workpiece and the tool, they are cold ends at the thermocouple and the electromagnetic force are proportional to the temperature difference is produced. So these are some thermocouple techniques. So basically, we require for example, from at the end of the tool end and the workpiece also at the end of the workpiece, which is joined together and electromagnetic force are generated. And after that, you will find the temperature differences before temperature difference will produce at the between the surface of temperature and the tool. So it is detected by some type of techniques also. The following point, it is that the first, that is the workpiece is insulated from the chuck and telestroke center. First point, the workpiece is insulated from the chuck and the telestroke center. Second, the end of workpiece is connected to a copper wire, which dipped with mercury will enable fracture or we can say further connection serval as called end. So the workpiece is insulated from the chuck and telestroke center. The end of the workpiece is connected to a copper wire and which dipped in the mercury, or we can say that a cup engage or enable the further connection serval and coolant. Third point, at this point and a connection from the tool provide output for connection to a milling voltmeter. So this point and a connection from the tool provide output for the connection to a milling voltmeter is required for to identify the surface integrating zone. Second is, it is possible to obtain the calibrator curve between the tool temperature and the electromagnetic force by the laboratory method. So these all are the some points we cover to find out the temperature distribution zone in the metal cutting and as well as to find out the tool conditions or we can say tool temperature particularly or the workpiece material affected by the particular temperature. So it will be also discussed in the some time. It will be represented with the help of the some following point. It will be calculated by surface. Second, that is the embedded thermocouple. The temperature thermocouple are embedded in the fine holes enrolled in the high speed steel tool. From the bottom face up to a fixed distance from the rack face. And this arrangement enable measurement of temperature at several point along the rack face of the tool. So the thermocouple are embedded in the fine holes enrolled in the HSS tool from the bottom of face up the fixed distance from the rack face. This arrangement enables the measure of the temperature at several point along the rack face that is indicated by the embedded thermocouple. How to calculate the spindle-speed the tool from the bottom face and from the top face and fixed to the rack angle rack face and to calculate the temperature between them and what range are from minimum to maximum are occur on the surface of chip, surface of workpiece and surface of the tool. So these all are the measurement techniques we will be calculated by the embedded thermocouple, which is a very good techniques for also find out the temperature on the surface of a workpiece and the tool and chip also. Third one is that is infrared photography technique. That is this infrared or we can say the techniques. This techniques of temperature measurement is based on the taking the photograph of the side face of tool chip while cutting and comparing them the strip with that whose temperature are known. So this temperature of we can say that the measurement by the taking the photographs of the side face of tool chip while cutting. and compare after them that strip and whose temperature are known. Because we know that the first of all, you have to measure the some standard parameter, that is the cutting speed depth of our computer, are the responsible parameter we can decrease the temperature or to decrease the temperature on the surface. So if the all the ambient thermocouple and any other type of temperature thermocouple are not responsible and do not give the response accurately, so you just prefer for the infrared photography technique, which is very helpful and to because it's really easy to take this photo and just compare that infrared red zone and to indicate by that this portion is maximum. We can say that is the maximum temperature occur. So we just calculate that portion and compared with the strips, other strips which is affected by the temperature already on surface of metal. So maximum temperature you will be detected by the infrared photography techniques, which is easy, but sometimes it can say it will not very easy to use because it has a difficulty to take the photographs during the metal cutting because difficulty to understand the following factors with the help of the photograph. So sometimes it will be difficult to understand how to calculate and how to measure this type of problems regarding to infrared photography technique. So in infrared photography technique, these techniques are temperature measurement is based on the taking photographs of the slide tool of the chip and with cutting the compared with the stream. Most temperature are known as, is known as the infrared photography technique. Now the second one is that is the cutting temperature. It is the most important, the elastic deformation and the plastic deformation. Elastic deformation, that means the energy required for the operation is stored in the material. Just keep in mind that the energy required, the what energy required for the operation is stored in the material as strain energy and do not supply the heat is generated. Is known as the elastic deformation. That is, we can say that the energy stored for the operation and when the during the strain energy, the strain energy, that means change in dimensional time, that is, no heat is generated, that is, we can say that the elastic deformation. Second one is a plastic deformation, that is indicated by the most of the energy used is converted into the heat, the plastic deformation. Because most of the energy are used is converted into heat and the plane are completely converted. That is, when material are removed from the tool and completely converted into a chip, it also known as elastic deformation, where that in that place also the most of the energy used in the converting as a heat. So these are the some deformations, elastic and plastic. Elastic is again when repeating for the reminder, that is the energy required for the operation. It is stored in the material as strain energy and no heat is generated. Whereas the plastic deformation, most of the energy used in the converting as heat, which is not right at the due to because the metal removal process are from there. Due to removing of the metal, due to maintain the we can say the surface structure. For maintain the material or for reducing the quality of the surface, it will have to understand the plastic deformation and how increasing or decreasing. And which of the, because we don't have the elastic deformation basically means the utilization of cutting the metal, but it not completely deformed or it will be regain again if the force is removed. But when the completely converted and the formation of the chip are generated with the high energy used as a heat, so this type of plastic deformation is the required angle, required term to use for the maintain the quality of the workpiece before the workpiece will damage. Or reduce. So for maintaining the temperature of the coolant used or some appropriate tools we use for the checking, find out the special techniques we adopted for to maintain the quality of temperature distribution zone. Okay, so then the second point is that is the cutting temperature are important because the high temperature we required with the following points are the reduce tool life. Obviously, the cutting temperature are the important because high temperature required for that reducing the tool life. From that. Second is to produce a hot chip through post safety hazards to the machine operator. Produce a hot chip that process safety hazards to the machine operator. Second point is can you cause inaccuracies? Can cause inaccuracy in work path dimensioning due to thermal expansions of workpiece material. These are some diagrams where we will indicate it, or these are some techniques we will be removed for. Reduced tool life, that is indicated by the reducing the cutting edges, because you reduce the quality of cutting edges which not sharp, because that metal will not cut easy. But if you produce a hot chip and we save the hazards, that means the machine operator will be responsible for that. The cutting temperature are important because the high temperature are occur, and due to this high temperature, the some causes in inaccuracy in work part dimensioning due to the thermal expansion of the workpiece material. So these are some zone or distribution zone which will be able to be calculated by this, or where it will be understand properly with the help of the material to be used for that particular distribution of zone and to remove the material from the surface workpiece. There are different points. It is the effect of cutting temperature partially when it is high in most terminal to both the tool and the cut job. So the effect of the cutting tool, basically we require the effect of cutting tool particularly when it is high in mostly determinant to both the tool and the job. First is what required for that particular effect of the temperature to identify. Second, it is the major portion of the heat is taken away by the chip, but it does not matter because chip are thrown out. These are the conditions occur basically on the chip formation. That is, it does not matter because the chip are thrown out. This is a thrown out or the portion we do not cut the material. Or we can say that a chip are formation measure issue. Third, it is a attempt should be much or met such that the chip thickness take away more and more amount of heat, leaving small amount of heat to harm the tool in the job. And so amount should be made such as that the chip take away more and more amount of heat leaving. That is the point we have noted, that more and more amount of heat leaving, that means a small amount of heat section are harmed between the tool and the job. So that way it not affected so much. It will not consider that we can have more issues where we are arriving, because it will be happen sometime, because the effect of the cutting temperature are just made of some small chip formation. The more the chip formation, amount of heat will generate leave from the small amount of the heat. Okay, to form the tool and the job, because some small amount, sometimes small amount of heat will have defect affected by the any material, because it will not react with the other. So that's why it sometimes will be happen. It will be happen sometime, which is not required for good machining. Third, that is the next point. It is the first is the effect of cutting temperature on tool. So the possible determinal effects of high cutting temperature on cutting tool edge are as follows. First is a rapid tool wear, which reduces the tool life. Rapid tool wear. That is the most important material. You can understand it is rapid tool wear, which reduce the tool life. So if a tool wear is increasing, it reduces the tool life because the cutting edges are not sharp, and it obviously the tool will wear. And it will indicate that the reducing the tool life will be occurred, and then it will affect it on the tool, temperature on the tool. So first point I covered. Second point is the plastic deformation of the cutting edge. If the tool material is not enough hot, harder, and harder, strong. So plastic material of cutting edge is not there if the tool material is not there. So when the cutting edge, because the cutting edge to cut the material from the surface of the workpiece, if the tool material is not enough and the hot harder and the hot stronger, that for some time the plastic deformation will be occur. Cutting edge will be removed. Cutting edge, we can say the break, or the metal will be break for that. Third one, that is the thermal flaking and the fluctuation of the cutting edge due to the thermal shock. So the cutting flaking and the fluctuation of the cutting edge due to the thermal shocks are by the we providing the maximum amount of heat at the surface of the cutting edge. During the cutting edge considered as a chip formation where the maximum amount of the we considered a compressive forces are generated on the surface of workpiece, which is responsible by the cutting tool. Due to the unwanted, we can say that the sharpness are not given. For more sharpness, you just gain doing the grinding before the operation. We'll use helpful to cut the metal easily in a proper shape you want to give. So that is the build-up edge formation. Obviously, later if the temperature is too much high, that is a build-up edge formation and occur, because we know that due to the temperature occur at the surface of workpiece and temperature is very high, did not maintain by the any other instrument or extra resources, so that it will affect some time to reduce the quality of the workpiece and to increasing the we can say price money for reducing the this workpiece. It will happen sometime, but we can say that the most of the time will be understand and some build up cheaper formation, but it will be considered as some time. It will not consider some time depending upon situation and how much area affected during the build up cheese. Yes, obviously build up cheese is having, but is not affected by such much more yet, and it will not consider as a negative part. It will be considered as a positive part where we require for the metal more. Second is the effect of a cutting temperature on the job, that is the final product we are fabricated is job. So the possible determinable effect of the high cutting temperature on the machining jobs are as follows. The first is dimensional inaccuracy of the job due to the thermal distortion and the expansion contraction during the and after the machining. These all are the some fundamental be required for the dimensional accuracy in the job and due to the thermal distortion and expansion contract bearing after the machining process. Surface damage by the oxidization and rapid corrosion burning, etc. So the surface damage by the oxygen and the rapid corrosion as burning by the is formed. So it is a responsible parameter for that, for reducing the quality of or increasing the temperature of the job. Third one, that is the induction of tensile induced stresses. That is the induction of tensile residual stresses and micro cracks at the surface are increasing. So with the increase in the micro cake, the quality of the circuit will reduce the quality of workpiece, reduce the quality of the chip, and ultimately the product will be reduced by the maximum temperature or stresses are generated on the surface of it. So to maintain for that, these all are some fundamental, these are some solutions for that I'm giving, that is to maintain the temperature of the workpiece and temperature of the cutting tool will be maintained by the cutting speeds, or we consider that the fluent we use. So for tensile residual stresses in the microstructure, the zone of subsurface of the part of the machine, which are the oxidization and rapid corrosion are increasing, and due to this, the burning of workpiece are to be sometime, it will not consider as a part of, we can say, good quality of material we achieve. So for increasing the better quality, for increasing the good surface roughness, or to reduce the corrosion problem, so this all are the some surface damaging, if will first be reduced, and after it, this all are the some problem will reduce automatically. Because if the surface damage damage of the workpiece are here and we not consider as a good material, and for the rapid we consider that material we are not providing for the corrosion or burning, so it will not help to understand or to find a clear way of, to maintain the quality of the workpiece also. So these are some terms that will represent for you. So this is the effect of the cutting temperature of the tool, which is not not a part of some special issues. Second is the positive effect of cutting temperature, that is a hot machining. So however, often the high cutting temperature help is reduced in the magneting of the cutting forces and power cutting power consumption to some extent by the softening or reducing the shear stress. Tau is of the work material at the cutting edges, or to obtain or enhance the such benefit, the workpiece material at the cutting zone is often additionally heated extremely. Now this setting is known as the hot machining, and it is beneficially applicable for the work material which are very harder and hard level, or we can say hardenable, with the like high magnesium steel, hand filled steel, and nickel harder and mnemonic, etc. So these are the some that if we consider positive effect of the cutting temperature or hot machining. During the hot machining, it will be considered the some magnitude cutting forces and the cutting power required for the machining operation. That is the tau is the strength, shear strength of the workpiece metal we having. So for we require about a positive right angle with the positive effect will be produced by then the cutting temperature. So for increasing the right angle or positive right angle or larger the right angle, or reducing the depth of cut parameter. So these all are the function that will affected by the positive effect of cutting causes in the hot weld machining. Second one, it is we can say that is the factor affecting temperature. That is of the following factor affecting the cutting temperature as follows. First is the workpiece and the tool material. Second is the tool geometry. Third is the cutting condition. Fourth is cutting fluid. So these are the factor affected for the material where we consider as the effect of cutting speed on temperature. The cutting speed at a meter per second and temperature at 80 degrees Celsius. For increasing the, that is for increasing the temperature or for increasing the cutting speed. The also it will be also increase in the cutting with the temperature, so an affected temperature. For these are the diagram which show that they are increasing the cutting speed, increase in the temperature also. It's not increasing the temperature, but increase in the cutting. So these are the some advantages and effect of the cutting speed on the manufacturing as it follows for that point. Next one, it is the control of a cutting a temperature. That it is already seen that the high cutting of temperature is mostly determined in the servlet retrospective. And therefore, it is necessary to reduce or control the cutting temperature as it follows. The first point is, a cutting temperature can be controlled in varying extended by the following general methods. Some first is the proper selecting of material and geometry of the cutting tool. It is most important to understand the property of the selected material and the geometry of the cutting tool, because if you do not find the geometry of the cutting tool, it will be reduce the quality of the work, and there will be chances that no will consider this metal as a good quality metal. So optimum selection of a VC minus VS0 compared without a satisfactory metal removal rate. So these are the some points we consider during the metal removing, which will be affected by the controlling of the cutting parameters. Third one, it is a proper selection and application of cutting fluid. It is the most important, the proper selection and what application on the metallic fluid have been having the no understand. That is for just to keep providing the metal surfaces are very high, or as well as the optimum selection we require for that. Two, proper selecting and applications. That is the proper selection that is cutting speed where we use and spindle speed where we use and what type of parameter selected for the a special issue and what are the application of the cutting fluid. This all are the some fundamentals we require for the cutting material or with the temperature of the workpiece. Next, it is application of a special technique is required as flexible application of a special technique that is required for a special purpose. That is, it required and some flexible and some fluid we required for this to maintain the quality of the surface and workpiece. Now, source cause of heat entering maximum, that is the primary zone, shear zone, secondary zone, we are also discussing already. That is to be primary zone as affected by the shear to maximum 80-85% energy converted in this area on chip, and secondary zone, that is the plastic zone, that is we can say that chip and tool are covered 15-20% energy, and last but is the zone, that is all tool and workpiece zone where the minimum 1-3% energy converted for the end. The thermal effect of machining. So discussing all the temperatures and distribution diagram, we can just show in the diagram. The distribution diagram show the heat and thermo isolated layer ligand used for that. For that, we maintain the quality of the surface and to increase in the cheapness while during the machining process or apprentice like this. So at the end of the lecture, I'm just asking some multiple choice question related to the metal thermal aspect of metal cutting. The first, that is the primary distribution zone in metal cutting operation is located at the options are around shear plane, B tool chip interference, C tool work and chip piece interference. And D is a tool face. The correct answer that is around the shear plant is answer E. Second is the shear, secondary distribution zone in the metal cutting operation is located at the options are shear plant, B tool chip interference, C tool workpiece interference, D tool face. The correct answer for this B, that is tool chip interference. Third question, that is the temperature rise in the primary distribution zone is generally due to the options are plastic deformation of metal in shear zone, B friction between the tool and the chip, C rubbing action of the tool piece with the workpiece, and D none of the mention. The correct answer that is A, plastic deformation of metal in the shear zone. Fourth question, that is the temperature rise in secondary deformation zone is generally due to the A option is the plastic deformation of metal in shear zone, B friction between the tool and the chip, C rubbing action of tool piece with the workpiece, and D none of the above. Mention the correct answer is B, is the friction between tool and chip. Fifth question, the amount of heat generated in shear pan is known as, that is the options are A, directly proportional to shear angle, B, inversely proportional to shear angle, See, it does not depending on the shear angle, and is none of the dimension. So the correct answer for this B, that is inversely proportional to shear angle. Sixth is if temperature heat, if a heat transfer to atmosphere is neglected, then the amount we can say average amount of heat is percentage on the tool. That is options are 70, 15, 20, 90. The correct answer that is 15% of the tool have transferred the heat on the surface of workpiece. So seventh question, if the temperature of atmosphere neglected, then the average amount of the heat is in the 7% that transferred to the workpiece. That is the options are 70, 15, 20, 96. The correct answer is 15% of the tool also, workpiece. Eighth question is by increasing the cutting speed, amount of heat generated. The options are increasing A, B, decreasing C, remain constant. Did not mention the correct answer, that is A. The option are for the by increasing the cutting speed, amount of heat generated, that is increasing. Ninth question, by increasing the feed rate, amount of heat generated, the options are increasing, B, decreasing, C, remain constant, and D, none of them mentioned the correct answer, that is the B, decreasing. So by increasing the feed rate, amount of heat generated decreases. Tenth question, last, that is the amount of heat generated in shear plane, is the options are A, directly proportional to the shear angle, B, inversely proportional to the shear angle, C, does not depending upon the shear angle, and D is equal to none of the mention. The correct answer for the question, that is the B, is amount of heat generated in shear plan is inversely proportional to the shear angle. So at the end of this, I am recommend some books for understanding the thermal aspect of metal machining. So to modern machining processes by PC Pandey, S.J. Shah, the writer and the publisher, Tata Metal publisher. Second is the machine tool designed at MK Mehta by Tata Metal publisher. Third, it is production engineering science, PC Pandey and CK Singh, standard publisher. Management technology by RK Rajpur and Tata Metal publisher, that is we can select publication. And fifth is machine technology, manufacturing technology by PN Rao from Tata Metal publisher. So if you have any doubt, any query, you will be asked me on mail, drop me a question, my mail ID, amit.tiwari@mygano.com. And you will be contact me on my mobile number also at 6903194448. Thank you so much for listening patiently. I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you.